I'd like to give you another update on Concordia University, Ann Arbor, Wisconsin, and where things stand, especially as it relates to the Michigan District and our continued involvement to see if we can help come to a great solution for everybody. We're looking for a win-win for both campuses. So a quick update on three different issues. The first is that I've worked with a network of people, about 20, 25 people, very well connected into Michigan and into Concordia, Ann Arbor, different constituencies. And we have put together a roadmap for autonomy at really the invitation of Chairman Berg from Concordia, Wisconsin, Ann Arbor. We've put that together about a phased-in approach to how Ann Arbor might become autonomous so that Concordia Mequon could continue to flourish and that we here in Ann Arbor would be able to have a campus that's flourishing. I passed that on to some of the leaders now this week, and that will begin to be reviewed and considered with the other work and the other data that the committee that's charged with thinking about autonomy, as that committee does its work. A couple of dates that go with that, that committee is meeting yet this week, and then they're going to have a final report. I'm not sure how that will be disseminated on May 31. I'm not exactly sure what will be in or not in that report. And then the Board of Regents meets again on June 6th, and it's uncertain to me what exactly might happen there, but that's going to be a very important meeting, and so I would ask that you would keep that in your prayers. And so that leads us to the second point I would make. We do have another prayer event coming up, June 5 and 6. It's actually going to take place in three different locations. It will be at St. Mark in Battle Creek, Faith in Grand Blanc, and University Lutheran Chapel in Ann Arbor. You'd have to go to our website to find the exact times that the different places will be open for prayer. For Concordia Ann Arbor, Concordia Wisconsin, the Concordia system, our whole church body, as we want to continue to be in mission, where in all things Christ is first. God invites us to join him in prayer. And so I want to encourage you to be a part of that. The third thing I want to share with you is that our board of directors here in the Michigan District did meet this last week. And as you know, the gift that we've asked people for is really set up so that people would give to the Michigan District. And then the Michigan District Board of Directors would be stewards of that gift to make sure that the gift really goes for what people intended for it to go for. And that's that Concordia Ann Arbor would be able to be open materially the same this next year. I know they have plans. We still have some moving pieces and parts, but our board of directors will shepherd that, steward that, that Concordia Ann Arbor is, again, able to open materially the same and also be positioned to flourish. You know, we've been seeing it flourish these last many years, some financial issues notwithstanding, but certainly it's been a flourishing campus where Christ has been proclaimed and young people are learning, being trained to go out into church work, going out into the community for their lives of vocation. We've seen it flourish by the power of the word Jesus proclaimed, the Spirit at work, and the Father building his kingdom. So I wanted to share with you those three bits of information update that we have put together, a roadmap for autonomy, and we're sharing that with leaders at Mequon. Want to invite you to be involved in continued prayer, and then also to let you know that our board of directors is monitoring the situation. We meet again in August. We'll see where things are ending up there, and we'll be good stewards of the gifts and the intentions of the people that have contributed to the Michigan District for the operating deficit that's predicted at Ann Arbor this next year. God bless you, and God bless our Concordias.